throughout this 1 hour, I want you guys to take something out. All right. Okay. So throughout this 1 hour, I just want you to sit relaxedly. Okay. I don't want you guys to sit seriously or, you know, putting me on mute and doing somewhere something else. Don't worry. It will be like a movie. I'm going to show you a short film here for an hour. So if you go to theater, how will you sit? Will you sit seriously? Huh? Are you guys with me? How will you sit in the theater? Can somebody talk to me? Am I alone?
Yeah, you're audible. We'll sit relaxed.
You'll sit relaxed, okay. You know, you'll be sitting at the edge of your seat. What will happen in the next? I'm talking about good movies, okay? I'm not talking about any other any flop movies. I'm just talking you. Imagine you're sitting in some, you know, detective movie. How it will be, you know, the next step. So today we are going to learn about you, okay? That is what the today's session is all about. So obviously, everybody is interested to talk. Everybody is interested about themselves, right? So I just guarantee you an hour of entertainment for sure. I want you guys to cooperate with me. So let's see how we can take this session. Okay, let's see what we got it here. So I think Praveen or someone have given a small introduction about me. And I would like to say something small about me. A small story about me. Okay, usually people like stories, right? That's how people tend to sell stories. I just want to know, any of you in this group have faced something unexpected happen to them in their life? Can I see by the show of hands, raise of hands? I don't want you guys to unmute every time. Just click on raise hands. Okay, so let's have it convenient for me and also for you. So for me, there were some unexpected things happening. I was 23 years old. I got placed in a very good IT company with a lucrative salary. I was leaving to Bangalore. I'm a Coimbatore born and brought up girl. So you must be knowing how difficult it was for me like a decade back to go there. And suddenly I was getting married. So my parents saw a proposal, they felt it was magical, both the families liked it. You know, I was here having a thirst for life, and I just wanted to do something. And I'm entering into a completely new phase of life, which I didn't even recognize. I was getting married. And I was getting married and I was going to Europe. Life was good in terms of a very good husband. And I had an adorable daughter and brilliant holidays to almost, you must be knowing how it is in Europe, right? So everything was good. Everything was brilliant, I'm telling you guys. But everything was good to see from outside. From inside, there was something so hollow. I felt very hollow. And, you know, there was a voice inside me saying, there is something out there which you can go and get. This is not what you're meant to be. Kitchen is not the place for you. Of course, everybody should work in kitchen. Even I do it. I take care of my family. I feed my family. But that alone is not my life. And then one day, I mustered up the courage. I went to my husband. I just told him, sweetheart, this is not for me. I'm not a person who can sit at home. Because I was finishing my master's and I was going for work. And I'm completely here. I can't mingle with people, you know. My in-laws, everybody were like mango family. I was like a tomato. A tomato can never fit in a mango, right? Just for an example, I'm telling you. Because I always wanted to go out and do it. When I said to my husband, he was telling, okay, whatever you want, you can do it. Since it's a new country, I don't want you to end up in a problem. Take 1 year of time. Do some course, study, or make use of my resources. Go and start doing things. What I did was like, I went, I did my entrepreneurship course from University of Vasa. I really wanted to start up my own little thing. And I started my little thing and I started giving sessions in, you know, all over Europe. And I was a keynote speaker for UN Women Association, Geneva's Finland chapter. And I was giving a lot of sessions. For a timid girl like me, it was so difficult to put up with these refugees. all these asylum seekers from, you know, some countries where they come as refugees, right? I was giving sessions for them. I was giving counseling. I did a lot of things. And yes, I wanted to pursue my career. As you all said, I was working as a HR. And I did whatever I wanted to do. I explored. I'm still exploring. It's not like, for some people, it will be like, you study this, you become this, everything will be good. They will be having a, you know, they'll be having a Google map so they can navigate easily. But for some people, it's not a Google map always, you know. We are not even traveling in roadways. We are actually traveling in water where there will be no Google maps to help you navigate. We want to go stop at a place, see if the land is working for you, explore. If it is working, good. If it's not working, set to trail again and go sail for a few more days. Find a place and again do it. It's the journey is like that. You will be like moving from one place to another place to another place to another place. Only then you can, you know, find what your real purpose is. What is your calling actually is. So after a lot of trials and errors, I found out teaching is my passion always. But empowering young women and empowering youth, empowering students is what is for me. So I've empowered like more than 50,000 students, young people. I've been giving corporate training and all these things. I was doing all these things. Now, why I'm telling you all these stories to you guys? Am I here to scare you or am I here to blow my own trumpet? No, it's not like that. So everybody, you know, they will, this is how they tend to tell their stories. Their challenges, your challenges, their success, and your success, they might tell, or the journey from the challenges to success, nobody will tell you. So today, this 1 hour, I'm going to tell you the journey, the bridge between the challenges and success. That's why we named it as Secret of Success, okay? So now I want you guys to tell me, before entering into the session, I want you guys to tell me what success is all about for you guys. Children, you there with me?
Achieving our goal.
Achieving your goal. Okay, then. You're all still kids. What can I?
Giving our best, ma'am.
Giving your best. Very good. Then? Anybody else? Boys, what happened? You're playing Clash of Clans or something? Putting me on mute? Huh? Only there are two girls answering me? Okay, all right. Listen, once again, just hold on. Hold on for a sec. I'm really sorry. I'm just forwarding it to someone who really wanted to attend the session as well. All right, I'm done. Sorry, guys. Sorry for the interruption. Yeah. So, you're all students, no? Ippo indha vayasula ippadi dhaan thonum. Success na vandu achieving the goal and all these things. Setting the goal is itself a success. Theriyengla, I was doing, I mean, I'll sit closely with people and I actually help them to set their goals and all these things. We'll talk about that more in the upcoming session. Only for 45 minutes more, so I just want to rush up. So get now in the point in your vechukonga na yeah, setting the goal is itself a success. So at the end of the session, let's unlock that. So now, success is not measured by, you know, by achieving something, or it's not a destination, right? I've seen a lot of quotes, success is not a destination, it is a path of life. You guys can talk more than what I'm going to talk, right? So it's not like that. Success in the sense, the satisfaction you are going to get, that is what is called as success. You should measure your success not through monetary aspects. You should measure it through your satisfaction. You're working, you're making money, you're making friends. And, you know, after all these things, you're having time to relax. You're having time for your family. You're having a very good health. This is what is all about success. Yes or no? Imagine, for example, let's take this Apple's former CEO. Yeah, he was a successful man, of course. Nobody can deny he has brilliant, brilliant designs, idea. Just for calligraphing, Apple insert money. He just, you know, I'm talking about Steve Jobs. He ruled the world. The price of the phone is still crazy, right? But he failed to take care of his health. What happened? He's no more now, right? So, it is a holistic success is not a single measure. It is a holistic success in many different walks of life. First thing is you have to be happy and healthy, and you have to be satisfied within yourself. Somebody said you want to give your best Shweta. I guess Swati or Shweta, somebody said. Yeah, every moment there is a success. Every second, unlock the happiness. Okay, whatever you do, put your 200%. I'm not telling 100%, I'm telling you 200%. Even if it is a small thing, if nobody's watching you, when you keep doing that, now your mind will get programmed in such a way that whatever comes in your mind, you can, you just follow the pattern of behavior inside you, and that instill enormous success. You are going to get a lot of success. So I'm a mindfulness coach. I talk more about the mind. Mind is an awesome, organ. I mean, I think there's a great debate whether it's an organ or feeling or whatever it is. Okay, let's take this as a phenomenon. Mind is an awesome phenomenon. I'm telling you, if at all you want to attain success, you don't want to work hard, you don't want to study well, nothing. I'll never ask my kids to study well at all. So far, I've guided more than 50,000 children, in the sense, young people, it might even 20, 30 years kids, or even people who are 40 years old, never work hard. Just do your work then and there. Focus on one thing at a time, more than enough. Put all your 100%. Do that and move on. If you do this itself, the practice will give you a lot of success. Okay. Now let's coming back to the story which I was telling you. People will tell their challenges and their success. The bridge or the way in which they travel, nobody's going to tell you. I've made it with some 5 points for you guys to understand it easier, and I'm going to tell you guys. And you all like to play a game, right? Let's play a small game. I'm going to give it for you guys to guess what are these five challenge. I mean, I don't want to tell. Okay, I'm not so good in keeping up, surprises. So there are the five aspects everybody will go through when you want to go live your life. Okay, if you want to go live your life or go work for your dream, whatever it is, there will be some things coming into your mind. Like, what if you fail? Do you know what it's going to take? Can you do it? What is that we can call it? If you want to go and start something new, this problem will come to your mind. What is that? Yeah, children. Children, are you guys all with me?
Ma'am, I didn't get you. Can you please come again?
I was asking, when you want to go live your life, you are planning that I want to reduce 10 kilo, and I want to go to gym every day, or I'm gonna go for a walk. You're thinking, right? Suddenly there will be some negative thoughts. What sort of thoughts will come in your mind?
Self-doubt.
Very good. I was going to give you some two, three more points. Self-doubt then. Fear, right? So let's go one by one. The first thing is doubt it is. So you guys are very, clever. You said it properly. Whenever you want to go live your dreams, go live your life, always, what if you fail? What if other people smile at you? What if you fail, and what people will talk about it? The doubt. Whenever you want to start something new, there will be doubt. When doubt comes, a twin brother of doubt follows. That is fear. You just scared. You get scared. Oh my God, if I don't make it, what will happen? That people will speak ill of me, all these things. Fear it is. And there is and these people, they stay in your head. They're not from outside, they're from inside. And they know to whom they're talking. They know whom they're addressing. They know your weakness. They live inside you. So they talk to your logic. So it'll be very difficult for you guys to abandon these people. So these people will come for sure. They should come, I'm telling you. And the third one, when you want to go and live your dreams, another one question comes. When this doubt and fear comes, there is another one annoying thing comes. That is called as overwhelm. You know what is overwhelm? You'll say, I want to get up early, and I want to do it in the morning. I want to work out. Oh my God! you want to get up at 5 o'clock in the morning. You're having a long day. Can you do it? Oh my God, like that. Every day getting up at 5 o'clock, you don't know how this journey gonna look like. So this overwhelm, can I do it? It will be very difficult. We talk to ourselves that it will be difficult and all these things. That is overwhelm. So I've said about three things. One is doubt, fear, and overwhelm. If anyone, if possible, please type that. Doubt, fear, overwhelm. All these three things, they are in our mind, no? If we indulge them, I'm telling you, they'll be like a tenant. They'll be there temporarily. If you keep on, if you get scared of that and you leave it, all the work, one after other, you keep leaving all the work, you know what will happen? The tenants will become into a permanent residence and it will be very difficult for you guys to send them away. So doubt, fear, overwhelm. Yeah, thank you, Swati Tyagarajan. So these three things I told about. And there is another one thing. This is not within us. This is from an external environment. I would like to call them as dream stealers. If you have a dream, people will come and steal it off. Be it be our loved ones, our best friend, our parents, or our spouse, whoever it is. People who genuinely care, they don't want you to, you know, suffer. Obviously, if you want to reduce weight, you're in diet, mom will always give an extra idli, right? She doesn't want you to starve. So this is a genuine care, right? One thing. Or it can be that auntie who we hate, who keep coming to our home and we just hate her, right? There are some aunties, they'll just come and talk all. We just feel annoyed. We'll be like, please stop it. Don't talk. There'll be some aunties, they come and talk like that, right? Oh, idellam pandreya, adellam pandreya, you'll be get annoyed by the way they think. I have this auntie who comes to my home once in a while. Whenever she comes, she makes sure, she make me feel down. She'll be like, this is the time you want to be with your daughter. She's still small. You want to take care of your daughter. Why are you leaving out to some company to meet some students? What are you getting by talking to them? What is happening? She doesn't know what is happening, right? And she even asked me, why are you going to Europe once in a while, leaving your husband here and going back and coming? Do you know what your husband is doing here? Oh my God, that actually is annoying. There are some people who do that as well. The fourth one is dream stealers. Please type that down. And the fifth one is challenge. So challenge is a genuine way, you know, it's a God's way of checking whether you're really sticking into the thing which you have started. Because starting something is very easy, but, you know, sticking on to that for like for long or forever is really, really hard. So it's a God's way of checking. For example, fifth one is challenge. Yeah, Aarti, thank you. Fifth one is challenge. Okay. Have you ever felt that you wanted to go in? You want to sign an important paper, or for example, your guys are all in Rotaract Club, right? There will be an important meeting. We getting more insights. And the mari or meeting irukapo veetla yaarka cheda cha irukum la, you wanted to be there in the home for them. You wanted to be available. I got selected as best student when I was studying in Europe. I've been awarded with a scholarship and a stay and a trip to Paris for a week time. I wanted to go. My daughter was sick in school and, you know, I can't go now. It is the real situation. I want to be available in home to take care of her. At the same time, this 1 week is a lifetime opportunity, which I'm not going to get it back. And which I got it for all my hard work, which I've put in, right? So this is a real challenge. God will be checking you whether you're still, you want to do it or you don't want to do it and all these things. So whenever you're going to start something new, whenever you're going to start something big, whenever you, maybe a small thing, whatever it is, you'll have all these five problems coming into your mind. So how you're going to tackle these problems, how you're going to tackle this and, you know, get out of this is the solutions I'm going to give you now. So meanwhile, I just want you guys to, you know, observe and talk to yourself and do a kind of introspection and see whether do you have this kind of problems. Because everybody have a different goals, right? Whenever you wanted to go do your goal, be it a small, simple goal, like losing weight or, you know, organizing something. When you are planning to do that, There should be any one of this problem, sneaking in, and it should have got disturbed you, right? Just observe what it is and type in if at all you had any of this problem, you encountered any of this issues in your life. Just type in so that I'll know if you guys were with me, or else I feel like, this Dhanush only. Yaradirkingla? Am I talking alone? I absolutely I'll be feeling like that. Huh? Like Kumar, I will feel now. So just type in. Whenever, or write it, write in your paper and keep it with yourself. That will be like more than enough. The session, I'm not your teacher here, like, with the stick, with like a ringmaster coming in, checking whether you did it or not. You do it, it's good for you. You don't do it, it's your loss, right? So, but I would really appreciate you guys to take a paper and keep it and write down this so that you might not know at the end of the session, you can actually come overcome the problems which you felt. Now let's go to the solutions. Whenever there is a problem, for every problem there is a solution in life, right? There's no problem without solution. If there is a problem without solution, it's not a problem, it's only an imagination. Okay, we should be smart. Whatever coming in our way, we should smash it into dust, and we should move on. We are all young kids, right? We had a lot of time, and I'm so proud of you guys. Apart from your studies and apart from your work, you still have got time to get into this Rotary Club and all these stuff. So the solutions I would like to tell is the first one. The first solution is, can someone unmute and tell me, have you faced any of this problem? I just want someone to unmute and tell. I don't want to know which problem you felt, but just tell me yes or no, whether you're agreeing with me or not. I want to know. If you're not agreeing with me, I can change the context of the session. This session is only for you guys, so I want you guys to take the most out of it. If you're not liking this content, of course I can steer the wheel. It's no big deal for me. Yes, okay. Aarti felt it. She typed it. Okay. Okay. Deepashree, what about you? I can't see your face also. Deepashree, you there? Okay. So I just want to check whether you guys are with me or not. Yeah, Shibi Bharati, are you here with me? Selva Ganesh, Sandhya, Ashrit, okay, nice name. Logeshwaran, Mukesh, Manikandan, Vivek. Hey, Dharani, you're here. Hi. Okay, guys. Let's make it Let's go to the solutions. Whenever you have the solutions, no? Okay, yes. Okay, you guys are with me, I know that. So the solution is, first thing is, whenever you start something, this will happen. This is nature of life, right? When you're aware these problems are coming in, that itself a very big success for you. The first solution is awareness, being aware of your emotions, all these emotions, this doubt, fear. Whenever you're gonna go live your life, doubt showed up, tick. Fear showed up, tick. Am I feeling overwhelmed? Tick. Okay, I'm on the right path. Make sure you're on the right path, because this should happen. Only then things will happen properly. No problem. Yeah. So it goes like that only. First one is aware. And for example, just think like that. Once you are aware of all these problems, you will disempower them. I'm telling you. Okay. நான் இந்த விஷயம் பண்ண போறேன், எனக்கு இந்த ஃபியர் வந்துருச்சு, அப்ப நான் அதை ஓவர்கம் பண்ணி பண்ண போறேன், அவ்வளவுதான். சோ நீங்க அதை அவேர் ஆனவங்க நீங்க அதை டிஸ்எம்பவர் பண்ணிடுவீங்க, ரைட்? சோ ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள் ஐ டெல் யூ டு அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் பெட்டர். டுநைட் யூ ஆர் கோயிங் டு ஹாவ் அ பர்க்லர் இன் யோர் ஹோம், எ தீஃப் இஸ் கோயிங் டு கம் டு யோர் ஹோம். வாட் வில் யூ டூ? ஐம் நாட் ஆஸ்கிங் யூ ராக்கெட் சயின்ஸ் ஆர் யோர் மேக்ஸ் கொஸ்டின் ஆர் சம்திங். கைஸ் கம் டாக், பி சில். ஆம் ஐ ஸ்ட்ரிக்ட்? ஆம் ஐ ஸ்கேரி?
Do we know beforehand that the burglar is coming?
Yeah, now you're aware. That's what I'm telling you. You should be aware. First thing is, you're
Maybe then
aware of
call
the
the
problem.
police.
You'll call the police. Very good. So once you're aware, will you be, frightened? No, right? You'll be prepared, right? The first thing is, first solution is aware. Second one is prepare. In the sense, Dhanush was telling that he will call the cops. What else others will do? We can have some security guards put in front of a home, and what we can do. We can have all molagapadi, all these small tricks which we do, all these things. We'll be prepared, right? First one is aware. Next one is prepare. And when you're prepared, now you're dare to call police. Now you'll be like, now let the burglar come. Let me see. Yes or no? You'll be having all these utensils to beat him up and all these things, right? So you'll dare the problem, right? Aware, prepare, dare. Because unexpected our vision nadakila nam vandu shaken aayiruvom idu nam expect the worst, expect the unexpected. Eppome ellame prepare aarunga. It's not negative thinking, it's like, you know, preparing for the worst. Negative thinking is completely different. If I talk about this negative thoughts and positive thoughts, it will take one whole lot of session for me. I plan a lot of things for you, you know. I plan nearly one full page, you know. I don't think within 1 hour I can complete all these things, like which I actually go to college and I take it for 2.5 hour session and I take workshops. I don't think, I'm afraid I could complete all the topics which I've planned for you guys. So how much ever I can give you, the maximum I'll try to give you, and you just you know, you just extract the good points and you just leave. If time permits, I can give you other session as well, where we can talk about mind, thoughts and all these things. Because once you get your mind right, you got your life right. And let's come back here. Aware, prepare. Arti Kanna, can you please type down the solution?
Yes, ma'am.
The problem, this is the problem of being a teacher. Always, I'm used to telling, write down. Now it's like, type down these solutions as well. Aware, prepare, dare. When you dare, do it with some care. Okay. When somebody's coming to your home, you'll be like opening the door. Oh, you're uninvited. Get lost. Will you say that? Is it our culture? This is something called as Atithi Devo Bhava, right? Guests are like God. So you don't want to treat these stupid guests like God. But I'm telling you, for example, I want you to do it with gracefulness, with some care. Whatever you know, there should be a grace in it. There should be, you know, people will love you for that. People will network with you, because networking is the new wealth, right? Not even money, but networking speaks a lot. I'm telling you guys. So if you want a proper network, you know, what you have to do is like, you want to be so graceful in your life. So you want to do it with care, especially with dream stealers. Dream stealers, the auntie, see, be it auntie or your best friend or your dad, your mom, whoever it is, your brother, whoever it is. They don't know what you're going through. They're judging you based on what you wear, but you actually cross that and you are going in some other path. Only you know that. They will not know that. One point. Second point, they don't know much to guide you. If they have known better, they would have guided you better more than this. We can't blame them always. See, for example, if your mom, she know only to a certain extent. There are some super moms who know everything, but still, always a mom is concerned. Always a mom is scared. I'm being a mom. Whenever my daughter is doing something, I know she'll be capable of, but I'll still be scared. I'll keep on telling, be careful. I can't stop that from doing, because that is the natural instinct of being a mom. So if I know better, if I know better about gymnastics and my daughter want to do about that, I'll be like, without scare, I'll tell her, oh, go on, baby, go on, do with that. But I don't know anything about gymnastics. How can I go and, you know, cheer her up? I'll be always scared and concerned. Yes or no? So the same thing. If they do have known better, they would have guided you better. So if they're misleading you, or if they're not guiding you forward, if they're not supporting you forward, you know, just forgive them. Forgive them and move on with grace. That's when, you know, that's when the God in you comes out, right? So you can do that. Next one, do it with care. Aware, prepare, dare, do it with care. And the last point, what it could be? Any guess? Yes? Any points about the last point? I think we are done with the 5 points, right? aware, prepare. I think I forgot to say about scare. Danush was telling, no, I will call the cops. If you call the cops, burglar is going to get scared, right? You want to scare your fears, whatever fear, whatever doubt you have. Scare them. Tell them, if at all you are doubting yourself, I can't do that. Do it and show. Take the steps. Do the hard work. Do it and show. Aware, prepare, scare. Do it with dare. And do it with care. All these five things you should do. So these are the five solutions which I would like to tell you guys for this problem. So apart from that, there is one big, big, big important solution. Do you know what it is? Any idea, guys? If you want success in your life, you want to follow this. You know what I'm talking about? Any idea? நம்ம ஸ்கூல் படிக்கிற காலத்துல இருந்து சொல்லிட்டே இருந்திருப்பாங்க நம்மளுக்கு டிசிப்ளின் டிசிப்ளின் இட் இஸ் இஃப் யூ ஹேவ் செல்ஃப் டிசிப்ளின் ஐ எம் டெல்லிங் யூ யூ வில் கோ ஹைட்ஸ் இஃப் யூ ஆர் நாட் ஹேவிங் செல்ஃப் டிசிப்ளின் யூ ஹேவ் ஆல் த அதர் ட்ரெய்ட்ஸ் யூ ஹேவ் ஆல் த பொட்டென்ஷியல் எவ்ரி திங் பட் நோ டிசிப்ளின் ரைட் இட் அண்ட் கீப் யூ ஆர் கோயிங் நோ வேர் யூ ஷுட் ஆல்வேஸ் ஹேவ் அ டிசிப்ளின் வாட் டிசிப்ளின் இஸ் ஆல் அபவுட் வென் நோபடி இஸ் வாட்சிங் யூ ஷுட் டூ இட் ப்ராப்பர்லி டெவலப் அ பேட்டர்ன் ஆஃப் லைஃப் Now, you know, we all tend to keep alarm, right, for the next day morning to get up. We everybody agree with me, right? Everybody keep alarm. How many of you get up at the time? You always press snooze. Yeah, technology is, wonderful creation is the snooze button. Yeah, everybody, even I have did that before I was knowing all these things, before I was reading a lot about mind, before I was doing the session. Sorry guys. Before I was doing, before, you know, I was, before I came to know about all these issues, I was doing that. I was procrastinating. I was turning on my, turning off or snoozing my alarm button. Many people, always they will have two things in the morning, waking up and getting up. You will wake up when the alarm rings, you will snooze, and you will get up somewhere at 8 o'clock in the early afternoon, right? You will keep alarm at 6 o'clock and wake up at the afternoon. I call it early afternoon, of course. I'm not asking you guys to get up at 3 o'clock in the Brahma Muhurtam or 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock. 6 o'clock, 6:30, so that you will have some time for yourself. Always have time for yourself. Plan your day. Not planning in the sense, not that, all budgeting plan. No. Just sit in silence for 10 minutes. I'm telling you that do it for some 48 days. 21 days is good, but 48 days. Consistently, without a break, do it and see, your life will be successful. You will come back to me. You will search my address and come back to me. This one worked like wonder, ma'am. Thank you. So sit in silence. I'm not asking you to meditate. I'm not asking you to become a Swamiji or Guruji. Sit in silence and see what all thoughts you are coming. Just observe your thoughts, because thoughts are what a human is made of. The mind, the power of the man is in the power of the mind. Okay? The mind is such an important thing, such a powerful thing. After doing research about this mind and giving a lot of sessions about mind, I named my company as ThoughtX, because that X is the deciding factor. Now, always in the algebra and math we read about X, no? It could be a minus factor or a positive factor, right? Whatever it is, that's why I named it my company as ThoughtX. Your thought is going to decide your life, and the X you want to decide whether it's you want a positive life or a negative life. Got it? So I told about the discipline, like somebody of you getting up at early afternoon and all these things. You know what happened when you keep pressing this snooze button? You might think this is no big deal. Every Tom, Dick and Harry turns off the alarm or click on the snooze button, right? No, it is a serious problem, I'm telling you guys. Why? Is because there is a research revealing a lot of things about snooze thing and getting up in the morning, making up your bed, all these things, small things adds up to your success. If you do it consistently for 3 months, do it for 3 months, you would have had 4 years, 5 years, desires which was not happening, in 2 or 3 months it will happen. Write it and keep. I am guarantee. If it's not happening, come to me. The same thing I do. Whenever I give in my sessions, I give all these things. I challenge my kids. I challenge my clients. I tell them, if it's not happening, even after 6 months, nothing, you see no progress, come back to me. I'll return your money. I'll give back your money. You can take it and go. Because this will happen. With so much courage, I'm telling, I can give back your money, is because this thing will happen, of course. If you follow, it will happen. So let's come back to this snooze thing. Why I was telling this, because, you know, your mind, I told you the power of the man is in the power of the mind, right? When you snooze, when you keep on pressing the snooze button, what happens is, like, your mind starts to believe that you're not able to do it. You're not able to get up in the morning. You're not able to do it. So when you aspire for something big, when you aspire to do something big, what happened? What will happen? Your mind will not believe you. Of course. Namle vandhi yarash namukit. Innik na ungalik session varana. Praveena has been coordinating with me for about a month. I'm telling her, yeah, I'll come to your session, that, this, and today I'm not turning up. And she's postponing it to the next time. I'm not turning up again. Will Praveena come back to me? No, right? And we are a human being. We are like that. And our mind will obviously be like that. Your mind will stop believing you. So, you know, if no one believes you, but your mind believes you, yeah, you know what will happen? If nobody is believing you, but your mind, you believe in yourself, you will attain success tenfold. When everybody believe you, you have all the potential, you have all the resource, but your mind is not believing you, I'm telling you, you're going nowhere. You're going to stuck in the same place where you are, even after 5 years, 10 years, a decade or 2 decades, whatever it is. You should have a self-faith. Only then it will happen. So, self-faith, okay, I'm a number. If you can get up in the morning, keep the alarm. Or else, throw the goddamn alarm off and go sleep peacefully. I'm not asking you guys to get up at all. If you want to get up, if you're having a commitment, honor that commitment. Only when you honor the commitment, you can go to the next level in your life. Your mind is not your lover to whom you can sit and cheat, keep cheating on. It's not your ex, right? Whatever you're putting in your mind is going to reflect in your life. I'm telling you, this is like for sure. It took me more than 30 years for me to realize all these things. I've suffered a lot to get to know all of these things. You guys are so lucky. In the early 20s, you're getting to know about all these things. There will be a lot of other sessions you will be attending also. When you get to know about always life, la ellame indha chinna vishayangala nam correct panna vendida irukum. Periya periya vishayangala thana set aayirum. Indha chinna vishayam set aanave periya vishayam set aayirum. Small steps, right? One at a time. When you keep this thing proper, the big thing will happen for you guys. I'm telling you. So I think there is another 15 more minutes. Or 3 steps irukku ungalku success ku. And the 3 steps na quicka enala evlo mudiyuma avlo quicka na sollirren. If at all it is possible post corona nama or 1-on-1 session vechalum seri illa. If you are going to have another one session, abdina kuda nam idha pathi in depth ah paakalam. I'm just giving you just over the 3 points. I don't want to leave you guys without telling these 3 points, because I want to honor my commitment. Adukapra enoda self conscious enna question kek aarambichirum. Are you a good trainer? Are you a good teacher? You planned so much things and you didn't deliver it to the kids. The kids are so poor and you didn't tell them. And you should not do that. Not like that. At the end, my session should be like, there should be a lot of satisfaction for me first, then you guys. I should be, my kids were enjoying my session. They took something out of my session. The session was good. They should not say, oh, the poor trainer did not have time. Not like that. She managed to finish it. So on the 3 points, I'm going to tell you, pay proper attention. The first point is, if you want to attain success, you want to avoid mixed associations. What is mixed associations? ஒரு ஆசை இருக்கு, அந்த ஆசை மேலேயே நம்மளுக்கு டவுட் இருக்கு. நான் சொன்னேன்ல டவுட், ஃபியர், அதெல்லாம் வந்து அது இந்த வேற ஒரு ஆஸ்பெக்ட்ல நான் சொல்றேன். You know, first one is mixed association. You will be having this problem with you guys. One second. The first one is mixed association. So what is this mixed association? You have a desire, okay? You want to be your own desire and go forward and do it. அதை விட்டுட்டு இது பண்ணலாமா வேண்டாமா நடக்குமா நடக்கும் அவங்க ஒரு வாட் இஃப் அனாலிசிஸ் பண்ணி பீப்புள் யூ ஆர் ஃப்ரம் மேனேஜ்மெண்ட் பேக்ரவுண்ட் யூ வில் பி நோயிங் பிசினஸ் பேக்ரவுண்ட் யூ வில் பி நோயிங் திஸ் வாட் இஃப் அனாலிசிஸ் பண்றது லேட்ரல் திங்கிங் பண்றது ஐம் நாட் டாக்கிங் அபவுட் ஆல் திஸ் திங் இஃப் யூ டிசைர் ஃபார் சம்திங் புட் யூர் 100% டூ தட் டோன்ட் டவுட் யுவர் செல்ஃப் டோன்ட் கெட் ஃபியர் டோன்ட் கெட் ஃபியர் கம் டு யுவர் செல்ஃப் டவுட் வந்துருச்சா ஓகே வந்துருச்சு ஃபைன் ஐ எம் கோயிங் டு டூ இட் யூனோ பி தட் badass person who's going to, you know, smash down the doubt or fear, whatever it is. Be an adamant person. Be very adamant. I'm telling you, if you want something, be adamant. And without getting it, you're not stopping it. If you do that, of course, you're going to achieve tenfold of success. Why I'm telling you guys, if you have a mixed association in enak venumana venda or doubt ye irukiradhu venuma venda ma theriyadhu apdi irukilla enna aguna unga mind vandu pathina 1/8 of your mind is conscious mind. Pay proper attention, kids. 1/8 of your mind is conscious mind. 7/8 of your mind is subconscious mind. Okay. Nammaloada education system agato, nammaloada society agato. The way we are molded is like on the 1/8% of conscious mind la da nama work panni palagirukom. We want to tap into that 7/8 of the subconscious mind to attain success. அது எப்ப நடக்கும் அது வந்து நீங்க ஒரு கமிட்மெண்ட் வைக்கிறீங்க அதை ஹானர் பண்ணணும் அப்புறம் ஒரு டவுட் பண்றீங்கன்னா இட் வில் நெவர் ஹேப்பன் டெல்லிங் ஐ டோன்ட் நோ யூ ஆர் ஏபிள் டு see this I didn't make any PowerPoint presentations but yes I have something can you guys see this I've written it for you guys okay to any aspiration in your mind seriya for and to neethu irukave kudadhu there should be no for and against points you if you when the moment when you have the for and against point you know what will happen you will be deserted you will be left alone nobody is actually supporting you ipo in the 1/8 of conscious mind da ungalku work agudhu appo enna agum obviously procrastination varum just imagine your mind is a factory unga factory la 8 employees irukanga or only one employee is working the you know working the hell out of his potential other seven are staying simple this one person has to concentrate comments for all the other 8 points yes or no will that all the other 7 points enna productivity irukonga company la and one person vela senji 7 per vela seiyalana procrastination varum you know what is procrastination you know appuram pannikalam appuram paathukalam we'll do it later abdingra mari solradhu How to overcome procrastination? There are some tools there. 5-minute rule. There are a lot of things. I don't think now I can tell you. If at all you are not strong in your own decisions, you know what will happen? You will not have this impetus to propel things forward. You will be staying stagnant in the place where you are. Now do the introspection, you know, and you know, see. ஒரு ரெண்டு வருஷமா மூணு வருஷமா கொஞ்சம் வருஷமா நான் இது பண்ணணும்னு நினைச்சிருக்கேன் என்னால இது பண்ண முடியல Let's take the weight loss itself as a challenge, okay? I've planned to do something for many years. I wanted to, you know, enakku oru blog start pannum, na oru blog start panni write pannum nenikiren, na oru YouTube channel aarambikkanum nenikiren, but it's not possible na procrastination and laziness. Sit and do the introspection. Indha maari na enna vechirken, for ellathukku oru vishayam irukum. 4 years, 5 years, 2 years, 1 year, enna irukku nu paarenga. And believe that. Stay strong towards that. Work for that. 2-3 months later, it will happen. 2-3 years, it will happen. That's the first point. And the second point, I'll just show it to you guys again. Honor your commitments. I think it's not clear. Maybe next time onwards, I'll come up with my PowerPoint presentations. I was just busy with so many other stuff, so I didn't make the presentations today. Children, are you able to see me? Children, you guys with me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Is it boring for you guys?
No, ma'am, not at all.
No, ma'am, not at all.
Okay, let's go back. I'm only having 10 minutes. I want to finish it on time. That is the most important thing. So honor your commitments. Okay. When you say, when you keep an alarm, make sure you're getting up in the morning. If you're not planning to get up in the morning, don't keep the alarm. No, sila pere. After my session, don't say, for this 1 year, I'm going to do yoga for this next whole year. No. Can you do that? No. Nammala pathi nammalke theriyum. 1 year la mudiyadu. So what we can do? Chunk down into small things. Always chunk down into small things. What you can do is like, for the next 1 week, every day I'm going to do yoga consistently without any break. So 1 week, keep it like that. Chop down into small things. This way you can do it. So that always you should make commitments and honor your commitments. Only then your subconscious will believe you. You know, namma already nammalku vandu we got that mindset, negative mindset mari okay idu namma panna matto nu and or belief poiruchu adu set right pannona eppadi panna you have to neutralize that thought. How to neutralize? Keep a promise by promise, word by word. Keep alarm, get up in the morning. Keep alarm, get up in the morning. Solli adikiradhu gillingraangala and mari do that, follow that, do that. Make commitment, honor your commitment. Make commitment, honor your commitment. Your subconscious will start to believe you. Only when your subconscious start to believe you, things will happen effortlessly for you guys, I'm telling you. Okay, so value your commitments, and so that's what it is. Once your subconscious is actually taking it to you, the next level, it will happen for sure, or everything will happen. So, மூணு பாயிண்ட் சொல்லணும்னு சொன்னேன். ஒரு பாயிண்ட் வந்து ஃபர்ஸ்ட் பாயிண்ட் என்ன சொல்றேன்னா, அவாய்ட் மிக்ஸ்ட் அசோசியேஷன்ஸ். டவுட்லயே சுத்துறது அவாய்ட் திஸ். கனா ஆர்த்தி, கேன் யூ ப்ளீஸ் டைப் இன் அவாய்ட் மிக்ஸ்ட் அசோசியேஷன்ஸ். உங்களுக்கு புரியுற மாதிரி கூட நீங்க போட்டுக்கோங்க. இஃப் யூ கான்ட் ஏபிள் டு, இந்த வேர்ட் வச்சு உங்களுக்கு ரிலேட் பண்ண முடியாதுன்னா உங்களுக்கு என்ன போதோ அதை பண்ணிக்கோங்க. நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன், கமிட், ஹானர் யுவர் கமிட்மெண்ட், ஹானரிங் யுவர் கமிட்மெண்ட். தேர்ட் பாயிண்ட், செலிப்ரேட். You know why I'm telling you celebrate? The love, hate, success, failure, happiness, sadness, இதெல்லாம் வந்து யாருக்கு தெரியும்னா, அந்த 1% of conscious mind இருக்காங்கல்ல, that person will know it. The 7/8 of your subconscious mind doesn't know. நீங்க என்ன ஒரு ஃபீலிங் இருக்கு, உங்களுக்கு என்ன இமோஷன், உங்களுக்கு என்ன இமோஷன் இருக்குன்னு அது தெரியாது. Are you happy? Are you feel? அதெல்லாம் தெரியாது. It only know how hard is the feeling. How shallow is the feeling? How deep your feeling is? How shallow your feeling is? Subconscious kadada theriyum, which is a very good thing, very easy for us to conquer our subconscious mind and attain success. Ipo in the where it was, I've mentioned a point for you guys, I'll show it to you guys. Wait, yeah, deep and shallow emotions da theriyum sonnadla. Ipo by nature sadness is deep, yes or no? If you're sad, you'll get grumpy, you'll end up eating more, if you have stress and all these things, right? So by default, this negative thoughts, sadness, id ellame vandu romba deep, adu nam onnume panna mudiyadhu. We just grown up in such a way, nam vandu andha mari oru environment la valandutom, idu yaarume nam blame panna mudiyadhu. You know, I told, no, for them, if others, our ancestors, they would have known better, they would have guided us better. Our education system agato ellame nammala inda ore framework kulla dhaan vechirukku. So what happens is like our guilt is so deep. Ethanal ayyo edha nam thappu pannitume edha nenachikkuvaangalo edha adu romba deep a irukum, adhu poi subconscious ku theriyum. Subconscious, when a thought comes to subconscious mind ku enna theriyudho, அது என்ன பண்ணும்னா, அந்த ஃபீலிங்ல திரும்ப திரும்ப வர மாதிரி ஈவென்ட்ஸ் கிரியேட் பண்ணும். ஈவென்ட் கிரியேட் ஆகட்டியும், அது அந்த மாதிரி விஷயத்தான் கண்ணு பார்க்கும். ஒன்றும் இல்லை, டெய்லி ஒரு ரூட்ல போயிட்டு வந்துட்டு இருக்கீங்க, புதுசா ஒரு ஜுவல்லரி ஷாப் இல்லை ஒரு புட்டிக் ஆரம்பிக்கிறாங்கன்னா, நம்ம கண்ணுக்கு அது படுமா படாதா? கேர்ள்ஸ் கண்ணுக்கு, பாய்ஸ் கண்ணுக்கு ஆப்வியஸ்லி படாது, ஏன்னா அவங்களுக்கு அது தேவையில்லை. வி ஆர் இன்ட்ரெஸ்டட். இப்ப பர்சன் ஹூஸ் ஹேவிங் லாட் ஆஃப் பேஷன்ஸ் சேஞ்ச், ஆப்வியஸ்லி அந்த புட்டிக் எங்க இருந்தாலும் நம்மளுக்கு கண்ணுக்கு தெரியும். இல்ல ஒரு மெடிக்கல் ஷாப் இருக்கு, யூஆர் கோயிங் ஆன் த சேம் வே. உங்களுக்கு வந்து அந்த மெடிக்கல் ஷாப் கண்ணிலேயே பட்டிருக்காது இவ்வளோ நாள். இன்னைக்கு வந்து உங்களுக்கு ஒரு மெடிசன் வாங்க வேண்டியது இருக்கும், அன்னைக்கு போனீங்க அட இது இங்கே தான் இருக்கா இவ்வளோ நாள் பார்க்கல. வி யூஷுவலி திங்க் தட் ரைட். அதுதான் வென் தேர் இஸ் எ நீட் அரைஸ் ஒன்லி தென் யூ வில் நோட்டீஸ் திங்ஸ். அதை தான் சொல்கிறேன் நான். ஸோ வென் யூ கீப் ஆன் ஹேவிங் திஸ் நெகட்டிவ் எமோஷன், சேட்னஸ், ஆங்கர், ஃப்ரஸ்ட்ரேஷன், ஈகோ, your life will only have that things coming to you again and again and again. I'm telling you, subconscious is like mirror. It will conspire the whole universal phenomenon to bring sadness to you if you have a very strong emotion to sadness. அதுக்கு நான் என்ன சொல்றேன்னா, அதுக்கு எப்படியும் சக்சஸ் ஃபெயிலியர் தெரியாது. ஒரு எல்லாரும் சொல்லுவாங்கல்ல, பார்ட்டிசிபேட்டிங் இஸ் த மோஸ்ட் இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் திங், பீயிங் சக்சஸ் பீயிங் சக்சீடிங் ஆர் நாட் சக்சீடிங் இஸ் நாட் இம்பார்ட்டன்ட். அதோட ரீசன் இதுதான். எனக்கு ரொம்ப நாளா இந்த க்வெஸ்சன் இருந்துச்சு. When you participate, feel happy. Yeah, I did something. ஏதோ புதுசா பண்ணிட்டேன். Okay, I'm happy. Subconscious தெரியாது நீ பார்ட்டிசிபேட் பண்ணி ஃபெயில் ஆனியா சக்சஸ் ஆனியான்ட்டு. Obviously, your subconscious is not going to know it. But you can fake your subconscious like that. Okay, I participated. I'm so happy about it. Feel happy about everything. Feel happy, happy, happy. Always feel happy. Feel thankful. Feel grateful. Feel grateful for everyone. Everyone, your parents, your friends, your teachers. Okay, இப்ப பேண்டமிக் இருக்கு, ஆன்லைன் செஷன் இருக்கு, இவ்வளவு ப்ராப்ளம் இருக்கு, எங்களுக்கு கூட இவ்வளவு டிஸ்ட்ராக்ஷன் இல்லை. யூ ஹவ் லாட் ஆஃப் டிஸ்ட்ராக்ஷன். ஈவன் எனக்கே ஒரு செஷன் பிளான் பண்ணோம் அப்படின்னா ஐ கெட் லாட் ஆஃப் டிஸ்ட்ராக்ஷன். யூனோ இன்ஸ்டா செக் பண்ண போவேன், அப்படியே நெட்ஃபிளிக்ஸ் போறது, ஒரு ஒரு சீரியல் ஒரு சீரியல் ஒரு எபிசோடுன்னு உட்கார வேண்டியது, அஞ்சு எபிசோடு பார்க்க வேண்டியது. த்ரூ அவுட் த நைட் ஐ எண்ட் அப் லூசிங் மை ஸ்லீப். இட்ஸ் தேர் ஃபார் எவ்ரி ஹியூமன் பீயிங். It's very natural. How we are going to get rid of that? Don't feel guilty for that. Don't become a self-critic. Oh, nana, I make an serious path to come today. Anje, 5 hours I wasted. What? So what? How can I? Okay, I got a pleasure from that, right? Next, tomorrow, they put on the 5 hours, na productive up andra, and I want to avoid that. Adhu konjam conscious, we want to take it forward like that. ஒரே நல்ல விஷயம் என்னன்னா, சப்கான்சியஸ்க்கு பாசிட்டிவ் அந்த சக்சஸ் ஃபெயிலியர் தெரியாதங்காட்டி, ஈவன் இன் யோர் டியூரிங் யோர் ஃபெயிலியர், டோன்ட் டேக் ஃபெயிலியர் இன் டு யோர் ஹார்ட், டோன்ட் பிரிங் இட் யுவர் ஹார்ட். கோ டூ சம்திங் வாட் யூ லைக். வாட் ஐ டூ இஸ் லைக், வென் ஐ எம் சேட் ஐ கோ ஃபார் ஷாப்பிங், ஐ கோ டு விண்டோ ஷாப்பிங். பிகாஸ் வென் யூ ஆர் ஸ்ட்ரெஸ் யூ எண்ட் அப் ஈட் மோர், யூ எண்ட் அப் ஷாப் மோர், தேர் ஆர் சம் ப்ராப்ளம். ஸோ யூ ஹவ் டு பி ரியலி கேர்ஃபுல் வித் தட். ஸோ ஐ ஓன்லி டூ விண்டோ ஷாப்பிங். ஸோ ஐ லைக் ஷாப்பிங், ஸோ ஐ டூ தட். கோ சி வாட் யூ லைக். யூ லைக் பிளேயிங் கேம், play the game. You like watching some movie, watch the movie. You like playing with a pet, wow, go do that. You like talking to someone, your best friend or your whoever it is, you can go talk to them. Whatever makes you feel relaxed, go play tennis, go do something, go for a walk or distract yourself. Onnu illa vadivel comedy potu ukandukonga, see memes paathu ukandukonga, you will forget everything. So learn to celebrate, learn to cherish your life. Always, you should always learn to celebrate, celebrate and stay happy, okay? In this way, what happens is like you can, your subconscious will be programmed to happiness and it will pull out all the happiness vibes from the whole universe and you will be happy after that. All happy people will come to you. நீங்களே பார்ப்பீங்க. Things are happening effortlessly. நான் நினைச்சதெல்லாம் நடக்கும். நீங்க ஒரு பாசிட்டிவ் பீ த சேஞ்ச் யூ வாண்ட் டு சேஞ்ச் இன் காந்தி சொன்ன மாதிரி, நீங்க ஒரு பாசிட்டிவ் பர்சனா இருக்கும்போது எல்லா பாசிட்டிவ் பர்சனும் உங்களை நோக்கி வருவாங்க. யூ வில் சீ யூ வில் பி க்ளோயிங், யூ வில் பி சோ ஹாப்பி. அண்ட் வித் தட் நோட், ஐ வாண்ட் யூ கைஸ் டு ஸ்மைல், லவ், சோ தட் இட் யூனோ இட் கிவ்ஸ் யூ லாட் ஆஃப் எனர்ஜி அண்ட் ஹாப்பினஸ். வென் யூ ஸ்மைல் ஆல் யுவர் செல்ஸ் நோ இட் கெட் ரிஜுவினேட்டட் அண்ட் யூ யுவர் சப்கான்சியஸ் ஆல்சோ வில் பி ஹாப்பி. நோ ஃபார் அ மினிட் can you guys turn on your video and can you just laugh? I want to see who's laughing good. Laugh loudly, I want to see. Can you turn on your video and laugh? Yes, it's 5:59. I'm very particular. By 6 o'clock, I want to end this session. Can somebody turn on your, I want some volunteers. Not everybody have to turn on their video. I want some volunteers, turn on your video and laugh with me. Guys, you there? Children? Oh my God, that's such an awkward silence. What happened to you guys? Are you guys there? Or I'm here like leftover like Kumar, nobody's there. Yes,
ma'am. We are here, ma'am.
Okay, then what? Turn on your camera and smile. What there and this? Laugh. Show me your beautiful faces. I'm so excited to see you all. பாதி பேர் படுத்துட்டு கேட்டுட்டு இருப்பாங்க, இப்பதான் போய் தலசிவ போயிருப்பாங்கன்னு நினைக்கிறேன். Okay, maybe if you are so reluctant about turning on your video, just turn on your just unmute your mic and laugh loudly. Okay, that's it. It's 6 o'clock. The opportunity is seized. Guys, look what sort of example you're setting, what sort of thing you're showing your subconscious mind. This is what I told you to improve. This is what I told you to, you know, not to do. Because if you have a commitment, you should actually validate that. And I wanted to end the session by 6 o'clock. I honored my commitment. I did it. And another important, you know, rule to success is, always seize the opportunity, whether it is positive or negative. Enna opportunity evlo chinnada irnalum seri, go seize it, then you will enjoy it. Okay, ipo na laugh pannunga nu sonnadukku at least voice word unmute pannit neenga rendu moonu pe smile pannirundinga, I would have been happy for all the 1 hour I spent with you guys. Edho something would have gotten into you nenichiruken, but still it's okay for you guys. Take it as a learning. Go always try to seize all your opportunity, and thanks for this opportunity. I'm very thankful to Rotary Club and yeah, Praveena, thank you so much, sweetheart, for coordinating with me so patiently for all the 1 month. And
yeah, thank you, ma'am. It's our pleasure.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you for enlightening us with your knowledge and for your valuable time too. Thank you, ma'am. Out of thanks. Bye. Even tap person Retractor Guru Prasad.
Yeah, this is Guru Prasad, Public Relations Officer, Rotary Club of Coimbatore Majestic. First of all, I will thank all the participants for spending their valuable time. I will thank Soumya Ma'am for sharing her valuable thoughts. Once again, I thank you all the participants. Thank you.
Okay, thank you so much. Okay, guys, all the best. Rock on. Bye bye. And guys, stay back. Stay back for a second. If at all possible, can you take a video feedback of my session? You have attended my session, right? If you can take a 10 video or 1 minute video, be it in Tamil or English, ungalapathi or chinna interaction. For example, I'm Deepa Shree. I'm working or I'm studying. I've attended the session in Rotaract, and in the session learning, ungalukku enna pidichidhu, enna pidikala. இல்ல ஏதாவது பாசிட்டிவா இன்னொரு பாயிண்ட் ஆட் பண்ணிக்கலாமா, இல்ல ஏதாவது கழுவி ஊத்தணுமா, வாட் எவர் இட் இஸ், யூ கேன் மேக் அ ஷார்ட் வீடியோ அண்ட் சென்ட் டு மீ. டோன்ட் வரி, இட் வில் நாட் பி ஷேர்ட் எனிவேர், இட்ஸ் ஃபார் மை ஓன் ரெஃபரன்ஸ். அண்ட் அஃப்கோர்ஸ் யூ கேன், இஃப் அட் ஆல் யூ வாண்ட், யூ கேன் யூஸ் இட் ஃபார் யுவர் ப்ரமோஷன். பிரவீனா வில் கோஆர்டினேட் வித் யூ கைஸ் ரிகார்டிங் தட். அண்ட் யா, ஐ வுட் பி வெரி ஹாப்பி அண்ட் ஐ வில் அப்ரிஷியேட் யுவர் ஃபீட்பேக். தேங்க்யூ, தேங்க்யூ பிரவீனா.
தேங்க்யூ சோ மச் மேம். Yeah, yeah, yes, ma'am. Okay. Okay.
Bye. Adjournment of the event.
The session for me now, victory is hereby adjourned.